Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Parlay Doc from OddsJam.com, and today we're going to answer a very frequently asked question that I get a lot from my social media followers, and that's, what is the points betting feature on PointsBet Sportsbook, and how does that differ from a standard or regular wager? Okay, so for those of you who have access to PointsBet Sportsbook, you've probably seen that unique feature called points betting, okay? So the biggest difference is this. For those of you who are new to betting, you are probably most familiar with what's called fixed odds wagering, okay? So when you make a bet on a spread or a total or a prop, you know once that wager is submitted how much you could win and how much you can lose. So those amounts will not change, they're fixed. So you kind of know what you're getting yourself into, all right? Now, with points betting, it's actually not fixed odds, okay? So you don't know exactly how much you're going to win or profit, or you don't know exactly how much you may potentially lose. I know that sounds weird, but you don't know exactly how much you might win or lose, all right? So this is somewhat of a higher risk, higher reward type of scenario. So I want to be clear, I actually don't recommend this feature for most beginning bettors and probably for most bettors. But for those of you who are looking for a little bit of action, you're going to do it for fun. You're going to be responsible. Let's show you how this works and how it's different than fixed odds wagering. Okay, so let's take a look. All right, so let's show you a real life example of points betting on PointsBet Sportsbook. So I picked the Kansas City Chiefs versus Denver Broncos game in the NFL. And if you click on their game, you go to the top tab, you click on points betting, and they're gonna show you the options here. I will say right now, because we're not too close to game time, they're missing the player prop options, but you would see a bunch of player prop options as well. But for the sake of simplicity, to show you an example, let's take a look at the Denver Broncos total points as a team, okay? So you can see here, you can bet either the over or the under, okay? So let's do the over as an example, okay? So right here, if we're gonna do points betting with the over, they're setting the line at 17.5, okay? Let's, for the sake of simplicity, say that each unit size, we're going to stake $100 per unit, per point, basically, okay? So let's say the Denver Broncos play pretty decently, okay? And let's say they somehow score, I don't know, 28 points total, okay? So you would do 28, okay, minus 17.5, which would get you 10.5 points. So you went 10.5 points over the line. Then you would take that and multiply it by your base unit, which is $100, all right? So you would win $1,050. That sounds awesome, right? But here's the downside of points betting. Like I said, let's say the Broncos get totally shut out. They suck, right? And they score 0 points. Then you went 17.5 points under the line. So you do 100 times 17.5, and you would lose $1,750. So this is what I meant when I meant high risk, high reward, okay? You can get your butt handed to you if things go sideways. And that's the biggest difference with points betting and fixed odds wagers. With fixed odds, you know how much you're gonna lose. You know how much you might win. With this, you don't know exactly how much you're gonna win or lose. You can see here, they set max kind of caps of the maximum you could win, the maximum you could lose. So you have a sense of the ceiling or the floor, but beyond that, you won't know the exact amount, okay? So that is an example of points betting and how that differs from fixed odds wagers. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. Like I said, please be responsible. I actually don't recommend this for beginning bettors. It's much better to become more experienced with straight bets, okay, with simple straight wagers on total spreads, props, versus doing something like this. If you're going to dabble in this, do, you know, just standard totals, points, spreads, some props, and just do it for a tiny amount. Again, for entertainment, for fun. Don't go crazy and think this is a smart way to gamble, okay? This is just kind of an entertaining, unique feature, and I would kind of keep it that way unless you're just a super uber-rich degenerate that could care less if you lose money, okay? Parlay Doc here at oddsjam.com. If you want to learn more about the smartest ways to bet straight wagers with positive EV, please check out our library of videos on positive EV betting. Until next time, guys.